Hi, I'm Jeff Wise. If you were in a life or death crisis, would you keep it together or would you lose it? If you're like most people, you probably think you'd do an okay job of keeping it together. But when the moment came, your body would shake, your heart would race, your palms would sweat, and you'd find it impossible to think clearly or take a decisive plan of action. And in the aftermath, you'd find yourself wondering, what was that thing that came over me? Where does it come from? How does it work? Those are exactly the questions I set out to answer when I wrote my book, Extreme Fear, The Science of Your Mind in Danger. I talked to scientists who were exploring how fear works in the brain. I talked to people who had survived wild animal attacks, who'd been swept away by avalanches and had survived plane crashes. I even had a few hair-raising experiences myself. What I found is that fear is an incredibly powerful force. It's something that can overwhelm us, even if we find or think of ourselves as being incredibly courageous. But there's also things that we can do to prepare ourselves so that when the moment of crisis comes, we can better meet the challenge. Fear isn't only about something that happens in a crisis. Fear is something that affects all of us every day. And the same techniques that we can use in a wild animal attack or an avalanche are things that we can use in everyday life, like a meeting with a boss or a blind date or a tennis match. Getting a grip on fear means leading a life that's richer and fuller and less bounded. Fear is a part of all of our lives. It's something worth getting a handle on.